Hey everyone, welcome back to Gare Fiction. I'm your host, Subhankar. After watching Godzilla vs. Kong, which I loved it, I was curious about how Kong could remember the way to Hollow Earth if he had never been there before. Is it like a fantasy kind of thing that calls him and is connected to him? But we already know the answer to that. Genetic memory. The movie does fill up the blanks in an unmissable detail discussed in a conversation between Dr. Lind, Ren Serizawa, and Walter Simmons. Well, genetic memory is a very interesting concept that has risen to prominence in the scientific community. And while doing my own research, I have found some pretty interesting studies which I am going to share with you in this video. So if you love it, drop a like and do subscribe and let's begin. To put it simply, genetic memory deals with the inheritance of memories from our parents or ancestors. So we inherit characteristics and traits from our previous generations, and according to this concept, memories are transferred as well. So what the movie suggests is that Kong inherited some kind of dormant memories from his ancestors who ruled over the Hollow Earth long time back. And when he visits Hollow Earth, that memory is activated, and that is how he leads them to the life force energy of the Hollow Earth. They also cite some examples like spawning salmons and homing pigeons. It is also believed that Mothra transfers her full memories to the offspring in the larval stage, and that resembles the concept of genetic memory. So in a way, she is reincarnated in the new body after her death while retaining her full memories. Whoa, that sounds ludicrous. We have memories encoded in our DNA? Well, it sounds preposterous when you apply that to us humans. But for other organisms and species, it is a rather different story. But first, let's understand some stuffs from biology and genetics. Through various researches, it is believed that memories are stored within the neurons. Neurons are special cells in the brain, and they transmit information to the other cells. Think of them like the basic functional unit of the brain. So memories occur when specific groups of neurons are reactivated due to a stimulus or an input. Now, in the biological process of reproduction, everything begins with the germ cells, which then form the gametes, the reproductive cells of organisms. And through a complex process, we get the offsprings. So offsprings inherit genes which are composed of DNA, and organize the DNA, we get the chromosomes. Offsprings inherit sets of chromosomes from their parents. So that is the gist of it, and I know I have skipped many details. Thus, in order to inherit memories, they have to come all the way from the neurons to the germ cells near the embryo. So is there a pathway, like a highway or a shortcut connecting the two? Well, if you ask me, I don't know. And this area is still under the microscope. But let me enlighten you on some studies that had been conducted over the years. In May 2018, David Glanzman of UCLA conducted studies on Aplysia californica, a species of sea slugs. He took an RNA extract from the specimen and injected that into another untrained specimen. The first specimen was trained to react to an electrical stimulus, and the same response was observed on the other specimen. Voila! As if the memories and the learnings have been transferred. Thus, in a way, the RNA of the neurons transferred to the germ cells, just like life finds a way. Moving back a little, in 2015, a team of researchers from University of Maryland conducted a study on Cynorhabditis elegans, a species of transparent nematodes or roundworms. They found that certain strands of RNA from neurons or information can travel to the germ cells in the offspring, up to 25 generations later. 4 years later, scientists from the Tel Aviv University took this study to the next stage by showing that RNA produced in the neurons of worms affects their offspring's foraging behavior through germ cell transmission. In 2019, Giovanni Bosco conducted a study on Drosophila melanogaster, also known as fruit flies. The species has a defense mechanism against parasitoid wasps who parasitize their larvae. Thus, they have an established egg-laying behavior. Now, it was found that the offsprings inherit the same behavior even if they had never faced those evil wasps before. Have I introduced you to some magnificent species? Yes. And are you clear about genetic memory? Well, no one is. But I hope that you have connected a few dots. And if I have missed anything, please do correct me. So basically, it's reactivation of certain memories or stimulus or information that is transferred to the genes. And that explains a little about Kong's connection to the life force of Hollow Earth. That's it for today. Thank you for watching this video, and see you soon.